This video, we cover hauling the boat out for hurricane season, then go on a whirlwind tour of Texas, Georgia, Colorado, Texas, Virginia, New York, and Texas again. Along the way, we buy a house, and we talk about what lies ahead for our next sailing adventure. It's been a very long summer.
'Cause even in the madness, there's peace, drowning out the voices all around.
So, quick warning before we dive into the video. The very first part covers us wrapping up, pulling the boat out of the water and getting it onto the hard. The rest is just a bunch of our travels. We've been to a million different places this summer. We purchased a house. We've done a bunch of different things. But the last part, Aaron and I talk about what our future sailing plans are, and that includes getting the boat back in the water and heading to Bermuda, and then the Virgin Islands, and then the Lesser Antilles for the rest of the season. Also, if any of you are gonna be at the Annapolis Boat Show, power or sail, we'll be around. Keep an eye out for us, and both of us are gonna be doing Cruisers University stuff. So hopefully we'll see some of you there. Anyway, enjoy. All right, well, after a long journey to Norfolk and spending the night at a marina, we are now crossing the entrance to the Chesapeake and heading to haul out at Zimmerman Marine. It's about a 30-mile journey, kind of our last voyage of this season. And I don't know what to expect when we get there. I know what we're supposed to do, and Zimmerman has been really helpful in making sure that we're all set up for it. But I was just working on my to-do list, and it seems like a very long list. We have about 36 hours to do everything that we need to do before we head out. So it's gonna be a lot of scrambling. And again, I don't think we know what we're in for. So who knows, it's gonna be interesting. We've got a lot to do in a short amount of time, and I'm sure it'll work out, but it might be a little stressful. So we'll see how it goes. By the way, something you might want to check that we just had to fix is there's a stopper at the bottom of the sail, at the rail. If you don't check, that'll come unscrewed, it'll drop off, and the cars will slide off. And then you gotta put your main up and feed those cars in. It's not hard, but it's a pain in the ass if you're trying to sail. So remember to check that. The mess inside as we prepared for haul out was pretty crazy. I'm not sure how we got all of this stuff on our boat in the first place. All right, we're about 15 minutes from haul out. The boat looks quite different. There's no jib, no enclosures. We've got everything done that we think we need done. I'm sure I've forgotten about 8 things. Pickled the water maker. Now we're ready to just get it out and then start cleaning. And hopefully we can have this all done in one day and get out of here. A little nervous going in here because, man, it is tight. And I don't know, I'll have the camera on so we can see if I screw it up.
Super narrow, and we had to come in at high tide. I was told to hug this pole as we came in. Luckily, there was hardly any wind, so it went smoothly. After the pole, you shimmy into the dock, and then you're all set. Hauling out was really neat. They moved this cradle right under the boat. Then they spend a lot of time adjusting and readjusting to make sure everything is exactly right. And then it's ready to lift out. That quick power wash knocked off all the junk underneath, and she was ready to be parked in the yard.
All right, after a very busy couple of days, we're done. The boat's on the hard. I think everything's put away. I'm sure I've forgotten something, but I'll be back in a couple weeks, maybe a month, just to check on things. And the people here at Zimmerman are really nice. They'll come check it out if I need them to check it out. So I feel like we're in good hands. Yeah, we're done. So just got to drive back to pick up William and Alan, and then we head to the airport and head home. I'm so excited to get back to Texas and see our family and friends and to start the next part of our journey. We're going to a gazillion places this summer. We're going to Texas and we'll run around there for a while, but then we're gonna go to Blue Ridge, Tennessee and Chattanooga and the Smoky Mountains, and then fly to Colorado and go to Rocky Mountain National Park and visit Denver and Colorado Springs, and then back to Texas for a little bit, and then Maryland, DC, New York, back to Texas, and then Switzerland, Germany, Amsterdam, and then back to Texas, and then maybe another trip, but then also the boat show. There's just so much ahead of us. It's gonna be fun trying to keep it all under control, because it's just gonna be so much fun. So anyway, that's it. This is it, our first season in the books. After the boat was put up, we made a quick trip back to Blanco, Texas to visit family and friends. It was hot and dry. The Blanco was almost dry in some places and completely dry in others, so we made the best of it and swam when we could. Hey, hold on, I gotta adjust the white balance on this. Y'all are really bright.
Behold my beautiful magnificent light.
Look at you guys.
Look how y'all radiant I am.
Yeah, do y'all get outside at all?
Moderately.
Before we knew it, we were hitting the road again, flying to Atlanta. We then drove north to the Blue Ridge Mountains for a week and a half of exploring.
So today we are in Blue Ridge, Georgia. This is the cabin that we've rented. We're here for a week and a half, and one of the things you can do around here is hike. So today we're gonna go and visit some waterfalls, because there are a lot of them. We're looking at Blue Ridge as a place for a land-based home, since we don't have a land-based home anymore. And we're looking for a place that is around a lot of things to do. And Blue Ridge seems to check off a lot of those boxes. So we'll see. First stop, waterfalls. Let's go check it out.
The Blue Ridge Mountains are very lush, and during our time there, we saw rain pretty much every day. It made for some really beautiful hikes. It was really great having all three boys back together again.
So, do you think we've lost a little fitness living on the boat for...
Quick answer, yes.
We've gone a whopping mile. We're sweating. Not breathing hard. Are you breathing hard?
Yeah, my heart rate's up.
Yeah.
140.
God, we should do more exercise on the boat. So what'd you say, how long did it take for us to go a mile?
28 minutes.
So that's like two miles an hour.
Hiking.
Yeah. We should be going like three or four. Yeah. We should be trail jogging. I got jogging shoes on. So what did you think of the waterfall?
It was awesome, totally worth the hike. 2 miles round trip. Well, 2.5 because we walked the other way.
That's right, because we went down the wrong trail. So do you think you're biased because y'all are Slipknot fans and you're not giving Machine Gun Kelly his due?
We had many spirited discussions on our hikes on very intellectual topics.
Yes. No, Dave, listen to this. Nobody knew who Machine Gun Kelly was in 2012.
Nobody. My problem with Machine Gun Kelly is that he's a marriage wrecker. He broke up Brian Austin Green and what's her name from Transformers?
Oh,
yeah, they were a quality Hollywood power couple, and then he just came in and boom, destroyed it.
As the days wore on and we did more activities in the area, we really liked being there.
So one of the other reasons we're here is we sold our house back in March, and we live on the boat, but sometimes we take the boat out because of hurricane season, and we need a home base. So we were wondering if this might be a place to have home base. It's kind of in the middle of the country. It's nice and cool most of the time. And it's just neat. There's lots of stuff to do here. So while we're here, we're going to meet with a realtor and take a look at some of the mountain houses to see if we can't find something that feels like a home when we're on land.
We actually ended up putting a contract on a house. Didn't film a lick of it, and we soon were headed to Colorado for a family reunion. This is where I ended up putting the camera down for the most part. We just had a lot going on. Our immediate family was 9 strong with Zach's girlfriend and Kate's boyfriend coming along for the trip, and it was just kind of hard to film everything. We did do a lot of puzzles, and I managed to film that. We did a few more trips, went to DC to visit my brother, went to New York to visit my sister, and now we are in the middle of moving our stuff to LJ, Georgia. And that kind of catches us all up to the present.
We're at the end of a really busy summer, and we've been traveling nonstop since we pulled the boat out of the water. Right now we're in Austin, staying with Aaron's sister, and that's kind of what we've done all summer. We've just been staying with friends and staying at VRBOs because we sold our house last March and we didn't really have any other place to go.
Like you said, we're back in Central Texas now and getting our stuff out of our storage unit, getting ready to pack the moving van and move everything to LJ.
Yeah, so we've got a road trip, all of our stuff to Georgia from Texas, which is about a 16-hour drive. We close on the house next this coming Thursday. We'll move our stuff in. We really don't have any furniture, so we'll have to go buy a bunch of furniture. We'll spend about 3 weeks in LJ. Then we go to, where do we go?
After LJ, we're gonna go to Lubbock. Our son is in school up there, and we're gonna see some really good friends up there too, and maybe go up to the panhandle of Texas near the Paladuro Canyon and go see that, and then go down to Fort Worth, and our daughter has a nursing school thing, and go to a TCU football game, go Hornfrogs, and then back to Houston to prepare for our river cruise in Europe.
So it's our 25th anniversary, and we are taking a river cruise from Basel, Switzerland to Amsterdam, down the Rhine, which So we've never been on a cruise before. We like Germany a lot. The beer tastes really good. So we're going to go do that. And then once we're back from that, we will be working on getting ready for the boat.
And we'll be back in Georgia for a while.
Yeah.
And then go to the East Coast again.
Yeah. So we'll go to the boat. We'll start getting it ready. And then we'll go to the Annapolis Boat Show. Both the power and the sail, because we have some friends at the power show. So we'll be there. We'll be doing Cruisers University, and we'll be there all the way to the end. Then we go to the boat. Splash day is October 24th, and then we get together with three other boats right now and cross over to Bermuda. So it seems like a way off that we're going to be sailing, but it'll be here before we know it. It's been fun doing all this traveling. We've seen all kinds of really cool stuff, but I'm starting to really miss the boat. I'm missing having a place for our stuff, and I'm missing the casual journey that you do on the boat, you know? I'm not going to miss airplanes and Ubers and VRBOs, so.
And I'm ready to get our new house set up so that we can have a home to come back to, our kids can have a home. To come back to, and it's going to be hopefully a respite, a place of relaxation for us when we're not on the water.
Yeah. If you hear whimpering, that's Fang. Fang, come here. What do you need? This is Annie's dog, Fang. He's pretty cool. Anyway, that's what we've been doing. I don't know if I'll make another video until we get back to... get back from the European thing. I'll probably make a video of that because we're going to be seeing a lot of stuff. But until then, there's just really not a lot of content that's interesting to people who are interested in boats. So we'll be back on them pretty soon. Next boat-related video will probably be of the boat show. And then we'll get back into regular video making. We'll have a lot of really interesting stuff to talk about, like how do you plan a 12 or 14 day passage versus the 3 or 4 that we've done so far. There are some insurance challenges that we've had. How do you get your boat ready to go beyond the Bahamas and go, we're going to go to the Lesser Antilles. Where are we going to put our boat at the end of that? All that stuff we'll cover in video as we go along. So I'm anxious to get on telling those stories. And we'll also have some fun along the way. So that's kind of it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in a month or two.